Hello and welcome to part 2 of my playthrough of Elite Dangerous. Oh, in the first episode we did the basic mission, basic tutorial, and the first mission. And today we're gonna try to do is get some combat in with, well, the stock Sidewinder. Now, I am playing Horizons just because Odyssey has a tendency to crash, and until I figure out if it's something wrong with my computer or it is something wrong with the game, I will stick to playing with Horizons. So let's open up the system, or not the system map. Open up the panel and select the nav beacon. There it is. And enter supercruise.
Идет зарядка FSD. 4, 3, 2, 1 FSD control.
So I am playing using a Thrustmaster Hotas, the Warthog, is what it's called. I still haven't gotten all the controls down yet. This is the first game that I've ever used the Hotas on, so it's still pretty difficult for me. Haven't figured out all the keys, all the controls, so for the first little while it's going to be really awkward flying. Now, the way I'm going to play this game is I'm not going to be doing the roads to riches or void opal mining just to get an insane amount of credits in a short time, buy an anaconda and be done with the game. This is more of a let's grind and earn everything slowly, because I imagine this is the way the game was meant to be played. Not saying that Road to Riches or Void Opal Mining is by any ways an exploit, but I mean, for me personally, just playing it slowly, grinding my way through ship progression is pretty much the way I like to play. Now, for basically my short-term plans, is to earn enough credits to outfit the next ship that I'm planning to buy, which is, I will give you a hint, probably the most iconic ship in the game right now, or ever, the Cobra Mark III, and I would like to buy it and have enough money to give it a decent outfitting so we can continue progressing with our game. The long-term goal, of course, is to purchase an exploration ship, A-rate it, or set it up to whatever the optimum exploration setup is, and engineer it completely. Might take a little while, especially unlocking the engineers, but it should be a good run. And then once that is complete, to go exploring the different sites, different things in the Elite Galaxy. Oh, what's my super boost? Control is... One of the downsides of playing with a Warthog is the lack of yaw control on the stick, so I'm using a sort of nibble how you would call it. It's like a little mouse pointer on the throttle, or yeah, on the throttle, which is really awkward. And it's pretty difficult to control yaw, but until I get pedals, I guess this will have to do. Now, I'm trying to find some wanted players so I can actually shoot at them. And then while we're actually just shooting people, getting their mounties, I will also try to collect materials for engineering. And I just want to start now, just because getting those is pretty difficult, from what I understand, and you need a lot of them. So I will try to get on that as fast as I possibly can. Sidewinder with no combat experience. Is there really nobody in this instance? What is up? Well, this is a bit anticlimactic. Okay, he's more of somebody I can take on. How do I change? There we go. Okay. Let's try not to die, I guess. Okay. Then another thing too, that's gonna be pretty interesting to learn, is the power management. Him down. Let's see what he has. Shield emitters. Where is my... No, that's the landing gear. Cargo switch. Let's pick up these materials. Oh, see? Yaw control is pretty difficult to do. Yeah, sorry guys, you guys have to watch this embarrassing display of flying, but as I said, I have not used a HOTOS before in my life or any game. So for me, this is a new experience. To be honest, I did play Elite before, but I played it briefly when it was just released for the PlayStation 4. And let's just say the Elite Dangerous on PlayStation 4 is nothing like it is on PC. The frame rates are way better, loading times are way better, everything is way better. Okay, materials. Good. Let's see if we can find any more resistant abilities. We'll scan you, but we're not gonna shoot at you. Oh, a vulture. Oh, and a wing of three. Ooh! Looks like the police have joined in. Let's see if we can give them a hand. Oh, there's the first. Sad that I have to resort to getting help, but at the state that I'm in right now, which is just a basic rated Sidewinder with nothing on it, yeah, that'll have to be for now. He's clear. Oh, big ships. Let's give you a scan. There's a combat situation developing in front of us. What is this? Londo Malari? Oh, never thought I'd see a Babylon 5 reference in this game, but hey, guess anything is possible. I always hated that character. Anyways, let's go. Oh no, he's trying to get away! Oh, come on, he's gone. And I will not be able to catch him. Oh no, no, they got him? Oh no. Okay. Let's... Power. Oh. He was destroyed. Why did I get a bounty on him? Anyways. Next target. Is he scanning? Just look at the contacts panel, right? Or no, wrong button. Dang it. Okay. That's embarrassing. Materials, alloys. Let's change. Where are you at? Alloys. Oh, 800. Never mind. That's far away. Oh, we can scan navigation beacons. Okay. Who? Oh, dangerous. Yeah, let's not engage you. Matter of fact, let's go back to the station and cash in these bounties. So, what was that station I was at? Coelho Station. So I think this would be pretty much it for this video. I will do most of the credit grinding off camera just to save your time and not have to make you watch my horrible attempts. Oh yes. Hardpoint. Let's go. Now. So yeah, I don't want to make you watch grinding all of this and then watching me embarrass myself. So I will do a lot of the grinding off camera. Also get some practice in with actually controlling this ship. So let's just head back to the station, turn in our credits, and that would be it. One more thing I just remembered that I need to keep in mind is the 75% throttle. Just so that I won't have to be doing loops of shame every single time that I try to land or enter a system or a station. I really do need pedals. This yaw control is really starting to annoy me. I haven't even played the game for a decent amount of hours. Don't overshoot it. I overshot it, didn't I? Dang. Loop of shame it is. Why not? I must say that the graphics in this game on PC are just amazing. I am running it at 4K. I wouldn't say that I have like a gaming monitor, but I do have a 4K monitor and the graphics are amazing. Can't wait to actually get out in space and explore. While I'm at it, I always must remember to request docking because I don't want to get blown
access
up.
Access granted. Adjust heading for approach to pad 1-6.
Pad 1-6. Okay, now you get to watch me get or embarrass myself. Trying to help. Success! Alright, let us
landing complete. Dispatching ground
start
crew.
Towards...
Welcome, Commander.
Let's see, nothing to repair. Advanced maintenance. Yes, might as well do that. And how do we turn in our bounty? So of which we have 487,000 credits. Ooh, okay. Contacts, I believe. Authority, yes. redeem bounty vouchers. Perfect. Let's go back. And let's see if our status changed. So harmless 26%. Great. So at this rate we should have enough credits to buy the new ship, upgrade it, get it as much as I can. I still gotta do some research about where to buy the modules of the needed quality. So until next time, have a wonderful day, night, or morning, depending on where you are. Services at this starboard are-